My God is so big and so strong and so mighty. There's nothing my God cannot do. My God is so big and so strong and so mighty. There's nothing my God cannot do. My God is so big and so strong and so mighty. There's nothing my God cannot do. My God is so big and so strong and so mighty. There's nothing my God.
Awesome. my God is so big and so strong and so mighty. There's nothing my God cannot do. My God is so big and so strong and so mighty. There's nothing my God cannot do. My God is so big and so strong and so mighty. There's nothing my God cannot do. My God is so big and so strong and so mighty. There's nothing my God cannot do.
In the beginning, God made everything. God simply spoke and the world came to be. He sent a flood and made everything new. He parted the sea and let his people walk through.
He helped a boy bring a giant right down. Joshua marched the walls bound to the ground. These acts of power.
To live here on the earth. He healed the sick. He made blind men see. He let the lame walk. And he set the world free.
He died on a cross. And he rose from the grave. He conquered sin. He is mighty to save. He went to heaven. And he's coming back. God's word is true. But if it's attacked, I'll look you in the eye and say, my God.
God bless you guys. I hope you guys are doing well. Alright, let's start today's lesson. But before we do, what do we do first? Good. We pray. Why do we pray? Awesome, yes. To have a relationship with God. But wait, what is prayer? Prayer is talking to God. Good. So let's go ahead, let's close our eyes and bow our heads, and let's come in prayer. Heavenly Father, we thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus, for everything that you've done for us, Father. Thank you, God, for the protection. Thank you, God, for the provisions. But right now, Father, we pray and ask, Lord, that you speak to us. Holy Spirit, we pray and ask that you prepare our hearts, our minds, and our ears, Father God, for your message. Lord, to you be the glory, and to you be the honor, in Jesus' name. And everybody says, amen. All right, good. All right, so this Sunday's lesson is going to be about Samuel anointing David as king. Again, Samuel anointing David as king. Well, you guys know that last weekend we talked about Saul. and how Saul did what was not good in God's eye. So God decided to reject him as the king of Israel. Saul now, basically, God is not on his side because Saul disobeyed God. So now God has sent Samuel to look for Israel's new anointed king. So today, we're going to open up our Bibles and we're going to read this story. All right, let's get ready. All right, we're going to start reading from the book of Samuel, 1 Samuel, chapter 16. Verse 1 through 13. All right, here we go. Chapter 16, verse 1. Now the Lord said to Samuel, "You have mourned long enough for Saul. I have rejected him as king of Israel. So fill your flask with olive oil and go to Bethlehem. Find a man named Jesse who lives there. For I have selected one of his sons to be my king." Verse 2. But Samuel asked, "How can I do that? If Saul heard about it, he will kill me." "Take a heifer with you," the Lord replied, "and say that you have come to make a sacrifice for the Lord." Verse 3. "Invite Jesse to the sacrifice, and I will show you which of his sons to anoint for me." Verse 4. So Samuel did as the Lord instructed. When he arrived at Bethlehem, the elders of the town came trembling to meet him. "What's wrong?" they asked. "Do you come in peace?" "Yes," Samuel replied. "I have come to sacrifice to the Lord. Purify yourselves and come with me to the sacrifice." Then Samuel performed the purification rite for Jesse and his sons and invited them to the sacrifice too. Verse 6. When they arrived, Samuel took one look at Eliab and thought, "Surely this is the Lord's anointed." Verse 7. But the Lord said to Samuel, "Don't judge by his appearance or height, for I have rejected him. The Lord doesn't see things the way you see them. People judge by outward appearance, but the Lord looks at the heart." Verse 8. Then Jesse told his son Abinadab to step forward and walk in front of Samuel. But Samuel said, "This is not the one the Lord has chosen." Verse 9. Next, Jesse summoned Shimei, but Samuel said, "Neither is this one the Lord has chosen." Verse 10. In the same way, all seven of Jesse's sons were presented to Samuel. But Samuel said to Jesse, "The Lord has not chosen any of these." Verse 11. Then Samuel asked, "Are these all the sons you have?" "There is still the youngest," Jesse replied, "but he's out in the fields watching the sheep and goats." "Send for him at once," Samuel said. "We will not sit down to eat until he arrives." So Jesse sent for him. He was dark and handsome, with beautiful eyes. And the Lord said, "This is the one. Anoint him." Verse 13. So as David stood there among his brothers, Samuel took the flask of olive oil he had brought and anointed David with the oil. And the Spirit of the Lord came powerfully upon David from that day on. Then Samuel returned to Ramah.
Wow! What a story! Just think about it. Samuel went to Jesse, and then he saw all of Jesse's sons, tall, strong, and he basically was saying to himself, For sure, this one must be the one. He's tall, he looks super strong, he looks like a king. But Samuel was just looking from the outside. Well, God for sure teached Samuel something. Don't judge by appearance. God had already chosen someone, not because of his appearance, the way he looked, but because of his heart. And out of all the older sons of Jesse, strong, tall, God has chosen a smaller one whose name is David. Now, David wasn't even at the house because Jesse figured, well, he's just a kid. Well, guess what? God's plans are not the same as our plans. And God had a plan for David. Out of all Jesse's sons, David was different. David had a humbled heart, and David loved and trusted God. And as we will learn more about David and who he is in his life, we will see why God had chosen him to be the anointed and new king of Israel. All right. So what can we learn from this? Listen. Don't judge a book by its cover. God sees what's inside of us, what's in our hearts. And God does not care about looks, how you or I look. One thing that we need to learn from this is that God loves us and that God has chosen us to know Him and to be His children, just as He chose David to be Israel's king. Just think about it. God chose you. He chose you. Just like He chose David. And according to the Bible, one day when we are in heaven, God will put a crown in our heads as kings, just like He did with David. Wow! So, God looks at people's hearts. My question today is, how is your heart? Is your heart good? Or is your heart full of things that are not good? Well, let's examine ourselves today. And if we see that there are things in our hearts that maybe God might not like, today is the day to clean it and get it out. Okay? All right. So let's take this time right now and let's pray. Let's thank God for today's lesson. And let's thank Him for choosing us to be part of His kingdom. Okay? All right. Close your eyes, bow your heads. Heavenly Father, we thank You, Lord. Thank You, Lord Jesus. God, to You be the glory and to You be the honor. Thank You, Father, for all that You've done. We know, Father God, that You chose us and not us chose You. You revealed Yourself to us, and we thank You for that, Jesus. So, Father, we pray and ask that You help us examine our hearts to see, Father God, if there is something in there that needs to be cleaned. Father. Thank you, my Lord. To you be the glory, and to you be the honor. In Jesus' name. And everybody says, amen. All right, guys. I hope you guys learned something today, okay? So I will be seeing you guys soon, all right? Love you guys. Bye-bye.